is, I think, probably most people's first look at the UI of the Nintendo Switch. So I'm just going to boot the game directly out of here and get to it.
Yep.
You guys ready?
はい。
Time to go on an adventure here. So we are going to start out in a place that is fairly familiar to anybody who played the game at E3 or who has followed our coverage. We're starting out on the Great Plateau, which is basically the introductory area of the game. And you spend some time there, and then for me, one of my favorite moments of the game is the moment you get to step off the plateau and into the greater world, because it's huge.
E3 ですでにゲームをプレイされている方はもうご存知かと思いますけれども、始まりの大地から始めますので、はい、ネイトの一番好きなシーンなんですけども、これは高いところからここからジャンプして飛び降りる、はい、ここから始めさせていただきます。
そうですね。ブレス・オブ・ザ・ワイルドは高いところに登ってそこからこう下にこうドーンとこうね降りていくこの爽快感が一番重要なところなんで、それが気に入ってもらっているというのは非常に嬉しいですね。
I'm so excited that you actually like jumping off of a high cliff or high places because that's one of the greatest features of Breath of the Wild.
Yeah. So we should say that essentially you can jump off the plateau in any direction. I mean, players are not, there's not a specific way they have to go. We're just going to choose to go in one direction.
どこの位置からでも、どこの大地からでもジャンプできるっていうような。
はい。
I think I'm going to head down here.
全部ここつながってますからね。遠いところまで。どこ行っても自由ですからね。
So you can see, as you can see, like even far, far ahead, that's all connected. It's all, you can go anywhere out. Anywhere that you can see, you can go anywhere.
I'm going to start out down here and maybe, I think we're going to go and try to catch ourselves
a
horse.
ネイトはね、馬を狙ってますね。
So I think Nate's going for the horse here.
So I'm going to try to land on it.Taming horses is not easy.
馬を名付けるのは結構大変ですね。
うまくやると馬の上にスッと乗れたりするんだけどね。
So if you're actually good and the timing is right, then you can get on the horse.
はい。で馬を捕まえにこうやってちょっとかがんでね、音を立てないようにして近づく。
And then one of the trick is to kind of duck like this, what Nate's doing right now, and then approach the horse quietly.
Get that.
Okay, all right.
はい、今馬がこうちょっといやいやみたいなしてますけど、最初のうちはね慣れてないんですよね。
So you can see at first the horse is kind of swaying from right to the left, and then it's not really obeying what you want to do, and that's because the horse is not used to you yet.
こうまあいやいやとしたらちょっとこうなだめてやるってね、こうして。
And then if the horse kind of acts up, then you can tame it a little bit.
ね、ポワポワっとしたようなこうやってね、エフェクトがね出ますけど。
And then you can see that little the pink effect.
Oh, easy, buddy, easy.
There we go. 出ましたね。
That effect right there.
こうやっていくとだんだん懐いてきて、馬がですね、ちゃんとしたところにこう歩いてくれるようになります。
And then the more of those taming effects that you get, the more the horse will be tamed. And then once it's tamed, it'll start running where the roads are on its own.
Oh yeah, so without me actually guiding it.
No. 僕がガイドしなくても道沿いを走ってくれるという感じですね。
そうなんですよ。
Yeah, that's right.
It's really important too, because I think that the world is so big that there are times when you want to ride and look around.Sort of examine your surroundings, see like a place that you might want to go next, see if there are some enemies approaching. It's important to have a horse that obeys the pathways.
世界がすごく大きいので、例えば周りをあたりを見回して何があるんだろうっていうことを確認したいのに、敵がアプローチしてくる時なんかもあるので、やっぱりこうやって道なりを走ってくれるってことはすごく重要な仕様ですね。
そうですね。
Yeah, that's right.
All right, so I'm making my way. I guess this is, we're going a little bit west here, but.
馬がね、ずっとそのまま普通に道を走ってくれるので、カメラでこう周りを見ながらね、移動したりするのは楽しいですね。
Yeah, like you said, since the horse will be running along the road, you can kind of pan the camera around and then see your surroundings and enjoy the view.
Got a little guy with a pack back there. So I'm approaching one of the many stables in the game. Maybe Mr. Onuma can tell us a little bit about that.
で、今ここ馬宿に着きましたけれども、馬宿についてお伺いできますか？
はい。今道沿いに歩いていくとこの馬宿があるんですけど、これはこの世界に各地にいくつかこういう場所があります。
So the stables are actually scattered in few places along the world.
でここに来たらこう馬をね、今野生馬を捕まえましたけど、こういう形で登録ができるんですね。
And then at the stable you can register these horses, the wild horses that you caught and tamed.
まあちょっとルピーを要求されますけど。
You're gonna have to pay a little bit of rupees, but you can register them here.
でね、一旦ここに登録しておくと、馬をこう馬でこう遠くまで行って、その先何かやってそのまま馬を放ってどっか行っちゃって、どこに馬行ったのか分かんなくなっても馬宿に行って馬呼び寄せてって頼むと、ここにすぐ呼び出してくれます。
So once you register the horse, when you're exploring out in the world and then you kind of get off the horse and you don't know where the horses are anymore, your horses anymore, you can go back to the stable and then ask for your horse and they'll bring it back to you.
ね、自分で好きな名前を決めます。
And then you can name it however you like.
Not Epona.
今度はね、Epona以外もいろんな馬でね。
そうですね。
This time around, you can dip ride all different kinds of horses aside from Epona.
Yeah, so the they're and some are easier to break than others. There are horses that are they have, tend to have more spurs. They have more energy, but those are also harder. You can't. I mean, you saw that first one that I was trying to land on. He bucked me right off. He tried to kick me. So, you can get a gentler. I think the gentler horses are easier to catch, but maybe aren't as strong when it comes to horses that you want to run.
馬によってはスタミナだったり速さだったりそういった違いがありますけれども、やっぱりちょっと強めの馬っていうのは名付けにくい。
はい。
でももうちょっと優しくて、さっきネイトが落とされたような馬ではなくて、もうちょっと乗りやすいような馬だと、もうちょっと名付けやすくって、でもスタミナとかスピードが足りなかったりするっていうような、そういうふうな面白い要素もありますよね。
そうですね。今こうやって馬に
犬が
来た。犬が来た。犬が食べた。
That was for my horse.
Doggy. The dog ate the apple.
That's terrible.
ほら、犬が喜んで。
The horse likes it.
So you can see that the dog was actually happy.
Look, he's following me now.
なんか
犬が懐いて。
懐いてくるんですよね、こうして。
そうなんです。馬とか犬とかね、いろんな動物にこう餌をこう食べさせると意外にいろんな反応があったりするっていうのも今回 いろいろ入れてますんで、それを探し出してほしいですね。
So one of the things we added to this game is you can give food items to the horses or dogs and then they'll start to kind of follow you around and be tamed, and that's one of the fun elements that we included. Yeah.
It's pretty clear too that the stables in this worldthis wild world, are places where human beings congregate. People of all races really come here. And as you see, I'm just talking to this guy, there's a lot you can learn about the world and a lot that you might need to do in the world when you interact with all the people at the stables.
でこの馬宿はすごくいろんな人があらゆるところから集まってきていて、でここで次に何をすればいいのかとか、世界では何が起こっているのかっていうような情報収集もできる貴重な場所ですよ。
そうですね。ここにここを拠点にしてこう旅をしている人なんかもいるので、いや、そこだけじゃなくて周りからもいろんな情報が集まってくるっていうね、そういう場所になってますね。
So there's a lot of people that are using this as the stable as a base and then are traveling in the world. So it's kind of interesting to see that you can collect a lot of different kinds of information here.
So we've of course discussed shrines before. They're all over the place. I'm going to jump into this one and show our viewers a little bit of the inside of the shrine. But while I did, I was kind of hoping that Mr. Miyamoto and Mr. Onuma could talk a little bit aboutthese awesome things that we have on the table in front of us.
ネイトが今祠にたくさんあるうちの一つの祠に入りますけれども、その間にこのアミーボを紹介していただけないでしょうか。
はい、じゃあ紹介しましょう。E3 の時にね、もうすでにご紹介してますけど、この馬に乗った、リンクのアミーボ。
So during E3, we've already talked about some of these amiibos.